Today I'm going to show you everything you need to know about unlocking Professor Palin. Hello ladies and gentlemen and welcome back to Elite Dangerous with Down to Earth Astronomy. It's finally time to unlock Professor Palin and today I'm going to show you everything you need to know. As always, we're going to go through the steps. First of all, we're going to show you how you get the knowledge of him, how you get access to his base, and then finally how you actually do the final favor to unlock him. So, first order of business, of course, is to get the knowledge of him. Now, the knowledge of him you get from Marco Quint. If you haven't already unlocked Marco Quint, I have a video about him up here in the more info icon, so I suggest you go and watch that. Once you have Marco Quint, you need to do, I believe it's one tier, a grade 3 upgrade. As soon as you've done your first grade 3 role, you should be able to get access to, he should tell you about Professor Palin. And once you have the knowledge of him, you will see that he is down here in Maya, which is down in the Pleiades sector, quite a distance away from the bubble, and of course this whole area where the whole Dark Ward shenanigans are going on. Once you are in Maya, here we have the system map. Once you have the system, we of course need to head to his base, which is located out here. Now, it might be that you can't see it when you get into the system, so do bring a discovery scanner, and I suggest you bring an advanced one, because this is just over 1,000 light seconds from the main star, so you will not be able to get it with an intermediate. So this advanced discovery scanner is recommended if you haven't been here before, because otherwise you will not be able to find this easily. Okay, so once we're at his base, and we have gotten the information about him from Marco Quint, you now need to actually get access to his base, so we don't have to go just yet. And in order to get access to his base, you need to have traveled at least 5,000 light years from your starting system. If you head over here to your right hand panel and go in under statistics and you scroll down under, I believe it's under exploration, here we go, you can see that it is listed. Yeah, as a third from the bottom right now, third last in exploration. It says max distance from start. I've been 25,800 light years out, but you need to get that above 5,000. Now, if you haven't done that, it most likely means that you are very new to exploration. And in that case, I have a video that shows you how you can fit a exploration ship for new players, where you can fit one very cheaply. So go ahead and click the more info icon for that video, and then that will show you how you can do that. And then basically just pick a direction and then just keep jumping in that direction until you get that above 5,000, at which point he should send you a message inviting you to his base. So now that we have access to his base, we then have to go out and complete the favor in order to actually unlock the engineering facilities at the base. And that is to collect 25 units of sensor fragments. Now, sensor fragments are materials and not cargo, so you do not need a cargo hold for this. But let's head out and I'll show you where you can get your hands on these. The first thing you want to do is to come to HIP 17403. And you can see here it's not that far from Maya. We're only just shy of 29 light years out, so you should be able to make that in just one jump. Very, very close. Once in system, you want to head to planet A4A, or moon A4A, sorry, that was actually the Maya map. Let's just open up the proper solar system map, here we have it. So planet A4A, here it is again, bring an advanced discovery scanner. And on this planet, you're going to head to the coordinates shown here, which is minus 34, and all this information will of course be in the description, so just copy and paste it from there. Minus 34 point, I think I wrote 98 because I'm a little bit away now, and minus 144.4. And once at this location, you get down into the crater, and at the center hill in the crater, let's get some lights on here, you will notice that there is some crashed ships in here, and this one of the ships is a crashed Thargoid ship. And this was actually, I believe, one of the first times that we saw Thargoid ships in the game. There was from these crash sites scattered around. But let's get a little closer, and I'll show you why we got here. Because underground, scattered here, we have actually these sensor fragments, which is exactly what we're going to need. And you can just drive around and pick these up. It's really simple as that. You can get a little bit more if... because in this area, see what's over here. No, that's narcotics, that's not what we're after. You get into the main part of the wreck here, You'll see there are also intact sensors. So you should be able to find a Thargoid sensor in here. There's one there. And if we take our gun from our SLV and shoot this one up. It will make this very, very eerie sound. But left behind, there will be another sensor fragment. And there you go, we can go pick that up. And I believe there is, you can actually see there are two more here. And once they are done, you should just be able to relock and then pick up more of them again. Just some final notes here. Of course, the sensor fragments, as I said, they are material. That means you will not need one rolling there. You will not need corrosive-resistant cargo racks, and pick up some extras while you're here because you might need them for something else. And so, as soon as you have your 25 units, it's just about heading back to Maya, back to the Palin Research Center, hand in the fragments, and you're now good to go to engineer most likely your thrusters, which I guess is why you decided to unlock Professor Palin. So, if you found this video useful, remember to subscribe to the channel, give the video a like down below, and until next time, I'll see you guys in space.